Hi, this is Ari Kast with stridepianotricks.com, and I'm going to show you a couple of the piano tricks I know for playing stride piano right now. So, starting with the basic stride pattern in the left hand that everybody knows, you have your bass note and chords. If you play some typical stride kind of sequence, you have something like this. Now, to add rhythm to that, a very basic stride trick that's used all the time is to play the same chords that are being played in the left hand, play them in the right hand, but instead of playing them on the beat, you play them just before the beat. So, playing it on the beat, the incorrect way, would sound like this. But that sounds kind of like a school teacher. So to play it more in a more stride-like way, instead of playing on the beat, you play just before the beat. You anticipate each beat. So with the full stride left hand, it's and then you can also anticipate not only the bass notes, but also the chords that are played by the left hand. In other words, do it in double time. You do your right hand action in double time. So you go. And notice it's kind of a call and echo there. It's like there's a strong beat, strong beat, strong beat, strong beat. And now, just to add a little more variety, instead of doing that kind of a anticipation before every single left-hand chord, you can also put in some gaps. Now, putting in gaps, basically leaving out a few of these right-hand anticipations, it creates groupings that kind of create larger rhythmic phrases. So instead of doing it with every single chord, like this, so those gaps they keep things a little more interesting. Next, to add even more rhythm, instead of just dropping your hand straight down, playing the full chord, you can break up that chord with a little accent, like a little hiccup that comes just before the chord. And the way you do that is lower one of your fingers. You can use any of your fingers. Each one produces kind of a different effect. But let's say we start with this finger. So if this finger is a little bit lower when it comes down, now it plays, then the rest of the chord comes in, follows through. So you end up with this kind of a sound. Or if you used your thumb to start, it would be. Or you could start with your index finger and then switch to the thumb. So index finger, index finger, thumb, thumb, index finger, thumb, thumb. So that produces some kind of cool effects like this sort of a thing. So there I started with my index finger, then played and then led with my thumb. So now, applying these kind of anticipations to our original pattern, you end up with something more like this. So putting all these tricks together, you end up with something like this. And if you'd like to learn more tricks like that, go to stridepianotricks.com.